your friend sent me a paper and said, you must read it. It's super smart. If you read it, you'll be twice smarter than before. You must read it. Okay, I can have a first look. Lots of authors, something serious. Something about artificial intelligence, okay. Maybe I can cope with that. Gemini, that's something interesting. Ooh, nice, simple pictures. Maybe you can understand this. But the deeper I go, I realize there's lots of math. Won't I be able to comprehend? It's pretty long. Oh boy. So how do you handle this? You know, complex formulas. If you live in 2025, you're a lucky guy. No paper is too difficult. All you need is just two things. Artificial intelligence to explain it easily to you, and super memo with incremental reading when you can tackle it piece by piece. Even if it's a 20 pages article, step by step, gradually and patiently, you can understand absolutely everything. The first thing I do is just simple copy and paste and get the article to SuperMemo. That's an easy step. The next step would be to get references so that each article is annotated with the right link, title, authors, date, maybe your own comments. But perhaps it's not a good idea to work on it before you start reading. Perhaps after a couple of lines you realize this article is not for you, or perhaps just not interesting enough. So before I do it, I'll just extract one large piece of data, extract, and I'll later use this piece to generate my references. Now I would like to start reading, but the abstract is horribly small font, so get the beginning, and I'll do alt backslash and delete text before cursor. You can also find it here, before and after cursor. I can start reading. LLMs have revolutionized the field of artificial intelligence. Well, it starts looking interesting. In short, it says, large language models have operated on words, while this new idea is to operate on concepts like the brain. Wow, this could be a great step forward in artificial intelligence. I'll read it and extract. So if it's something interesting, especially I see a nice picture here, let's illustrate the article with pictures. Control-8. Maybe this picture will be good to illustrate the article. Let's see what we have next. Oh, this sounds important too. Oh, maybe 3. Not too many because oh boy. You know what? Maybe I just take them all. It's hard to say which one is most important, so I'll be removing them incrementally or just leaving in a given extract those which are relevant. So you have too many, they become cluttered, you can't truly really focus on learning. Well, lots of stuff. I already start having comprehension problems. The large concept model is trying to perform autoregressive sentence prediction in the embedding space. What's autoregressive sentence prediction? I don't know. What's an embedding space? I don't know. Not a problem. That's why we have artificial intelligence to help. So let's take this sentence and ask AI to explain it. Autoregressive sentence prediction. The training process involves predicting a concept sentence based on a sequence of preceding concepts. This is similar to how LLMs predict the next token, but focuses on entire sentences instead, enhancing coherence and context understanding. Wow, yeah, now it's clear. How about embedding space? The LCM operates in an embedding space, which means it encoded sentences to high-dimensional vectors that represent the semantic content. This allows for language-agnostic processing, making the model capable of handling multiple languages and modalities. Encode sentences in high-dimensional vectors, okay. I understand more or less, but just enough to understand the sentence from the text and I can proceed further. So maybe I'll just copy that and paste super memo. In this case, I'll convert markup yet. Text, convert, markdown. And I'll mark this part as derived from artificial intelligence. I like to use colors to differentiate between different artificial intelligence tools. In this case, I use perplexity, so I will mark it light green. This way I will know it came from perplexity. We explore multiple approaches, namely MSE regression, variance of diffusion-based generation, and models operating on the quantized sonar space. My God, will I ever understand this? Let's ask AI again. Explain MSE regression, diffusion-based generation, and quantized sonar space. It's not gonna be easy, but I see mean squared error regression, something I recall from mathematics. If I didn't understand it, I could dig deeper. Diffusion-based generation. Something about clear image, random noise to blur it. This I can grasp. Quantized sonar space. I'll need to go deeper into this. Anyway, with super memo and with incremental reading, it's gonna be easy, just step by step, slowly, down to the basic, down to multiplication. Just to be sure, will AI be able to simply explain such complex formulas here? And actually, they look a little bit distorted in super memo, so maybe let's go to the original. Well, I can see immediately that I'll need more help. So I'll have to go deeper into Markov chains, noise schedule, Markov chain process. We add noise to the data step by step, where each step depends on the prep. Actually that's simple. So this process always converges to some understanding. It's just a matter of how many steps deep you need to go before you start understanding things. This process model schedule. This process uses the models to gradually add noise to data. Maybe I don't need to understand those formulas. Then learn to reverse this noise addition to generate new data samples that predict outcomes. Well, maybe all this is not necessary to understand the whole concept. Before I go any deeper, sometimes it makes sense to jump to the conclusion. Because maybe the final conclusion will give a good light, a guidance to how to process the rest of the text. Maybe not all of it is so important to understand the general concept. So, if I conclude that this gives me some new understanding of the whole article, then perhaps it makes sense to extract it. Extract out of order. For the big picture also, makes sense to look at some illustrations, maybe. Control click. This picture seems to decompose some sentence structure or logic. Looks like a concept map in the brain. Yeah, it doesn't tell me much about the article, but it definitely makes it look more interesting. How about this one? Control click. Words, concept decoder. Concept decoder. Arrow. It goes that way. Actually, I'll put this picture upside down to make it more understandable. So we go from here, words, concepts, encoder, concepts, and that's input, large concept. Wow, yeah, that's a big step forward, you know. When you extract concepts, that this could be computationally much simpler and much powerful. Yeah, I'm surprised they come up with this only now. Or maybe just didn't know. And words come out there, yeah. Man, the future is bright. Okay, let's keep reading. These explorations are performed using 1.6 B parameters model string data in order to endure when a scale of 1. We perform an experimental evaluation. Finally, we show that the model exists. Well, lots of complexity to follow, but at least now I have a big picture and I'm really excited. So tomorrow we resume from this place. Curiosity killed the cat. The subject is so interesting, I decided to return to it even the same day. I just went a little bit deeper into the text and did some analysis of chapters in between. You can see I reduced the number of pictures, so the screen is not as cluttered. Most of all, I can keep this model in mind. This is most important. Perhaps it should be just a solo picture. And the graphs were secondary. They'll be important in specific context, but not for understanding the whole article. At this moment, I have 33 elements, a couple of items. For example, I wanted to be sure and never forget what aggressive sentence prediction is, or embedding space. So I created a couple of clauses here and relevant items like that. The brownish color is copilot, and the greenish color is perplexity. I also use ChatGPT, I think somewhere here, or perhaps here. I used it to emphasize that this model is in sharp contrast to current LLMs techniques, which are heavily English-centric and token-based. By the way, we define a concept as an abstract atomic idea. Great. In practice, the concept would often correspond to a sentence in a text document. This is interesting, because if you go up the abstractness ladder, you go from characters to words to sentences, but it's to a higher level. True concepts, like those in a brain, like a human, happy human, which is a combination of two concepts. I made it all know that this is not how the brain does, so there is still room for improvement. And judging by the rate of progress, it's going to happen like in a couple of months. It's going to happen tomorrow. We just don't know about it. So great, great, great. And here I have an item which helps me remember the difference between the present model and how I see it happens in the brain. I can generate lots of items. Not all of them will make sense, and this will really come out in the wash. I prefer to make too many items than too few. And then when they don't make sense or they just evoke wrong ideas, they will just be deleted or reformulated. That's not a problem. They can be cleaned up. Once the model crystallizes in your head, you can delete items which don't contribute to that model. Here is an example of an item which I have no idea how it will perform in actual repetitions, but it seems important. Despite the undeniable success of LLMs and continued progress, all current LLMs miss a crucial characteristic of human intelligence: explicit reasoning and planning at multiple levels of abstraction. I think I'll come back to this today in the evening. Too interesting.